सप्तगाञ्जना गौराङ्गी श्रीराधे वृन्दावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि प्रिये वञ्चाकल्पतरुभ्यो शिखरमासन्दभ्यो च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानन्द श्री अद्वैत श्री गदाधर शिवसदी गौरभक्तवृन्द हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे मुखं करोति वाचालं हरे कृष्ण। सॉरी लिटिल लेट बट कैन यू हियर मी?
यस प्रभु जी, वी कैन।
यस प्रभु जी,
वी हैव गॉन थ्रू द व्हाट इज दैट the conditioned state, you know, these verses are actually difficult for me because I'm still in the conditioned state of donkey urine and the six anardas. They're choking my throat. So whatever I say in the, from now onwards is only what is a theory because I don't know, you know. Yes, give me a second and I'll load the presentation. Sorry. Anyway, so today the verse number 9. Let me read the verse. मदीशनाथत्वे व्रज विपिन चंद्रम व्रजवने स्वारिंतम नाथत्वे तदतुल सकित्वे तुललितम विशाकाम शिक्षाली वितरण गुरुत्वे प्रियसरो गिरेन्द्रौ तत्प्रेक्षा दलिता प्रतिदत्वे स्मरमना। ओ माइंड मेडिटेट ऑन कृष्णा the moon of Vrindavan, the moon of Vrindavan forest, as the lord of my leader Sri Radhika. Meditate on Sri Radhika as the most dear object of love. Meditate on Sri Lalita as her incomparable friend. Meditate on Sri Vishakha as a foremost guru distributing the teachings of love. And meditate on Radhakund and Govardhan as givers of the sight and love of Sri Radha and Krishna. So here, Vraja Vipina Chandram, meditate on Sri Krishna, glowing moon of the forest of Vraj, Vrindavan. You know, so Krishna, just give me 1 minute. So in this we have few things. One is meditation. Meditate on Krishna. Meditate on Krishna as the glowing moon of the forest of Vrindavan, forest of Raj Vrindavan. Just give me 1 minute. So meditation, one and meditate on Vrindavan Chandra, the moon of Vrindavan forest. Two, as the lord of my leader Radharani, Raghunath Das Goswami, you know, he is like Srimad Radharani is you know, he is worshipable Ishtadev. So as a lord of my leader Radharani, meditate on Sri Radhika as his dearmost object of love. So who is the Krishna's dearmost object of love? And meditate on Sri Lalita. Meditate on Lalita Sakhi as Radharani's friend. And meditate on Vishakha as the foremost guru, distributing the teachings of the love. Meditate on Radhakund and Govardhan as the givers of sight and love of Sri Sri Radha Krishna. So in this verse we have one, meditate on Krishna as Vrindavan Chandra, the moon of Vrindavan. Two, meditate on Srimati Radharani as object of his love, you know. Three, meditate on Lalita Sakhi as an incomparable friend of Radharani. Four, Vishakha Sakhi as the foremost guru. Five, meditate on Govardhan. And sixth, meditate on Radhakund. Five, sixth, Govardhan. And they, if we worship them, they give the sight and love of Sri Radha and Krishna. Amazing. So we are coming to the, actually we are finishing in very two verses. Manasiksha will end actually, you know. Manasiksha will we are at the ninth verse, right? So in three verses Manasiksha will end. So meditation, dhyana. So what is that? I don't know how many of you studied this nectar of instruction. In nectar of instruction, dhyana paddhati. So we have, you know, like, you know, shraddha to prema, right? Likewise, we have, especially in nectar of instruction, we have that meditation, you know. What is that? First is smaranam, chanting, right? So how do we chant? In chanting, the first stage is called smaranam. Shravanam and kirtanam, when they go very well, it is called smaranam. You know, right now, we chant, we listen, but mind is going away. So when chanting is very good, kirtanam is very good, and we are also attentively listening, how do we know our Sravanam and Kirtanam, they're going on well. How do we know? If both go well, remember, chanting is, we are chanting intensely, my Lord. Gee, what is this, my Lord? Please give me your shelter. You know, I'm the victim of greed, anger, envy, pride, lust. You know, anger. You know, illusion. You know, please, my Lord, protect me, my Lord. In that helpless mood, when we take shelter and chant, and we hear, then if both things go very well, it will translate to smaranam. So in smaranam, smaranam means meditation. There are four objects, four things actually. Nama, rupa, guna, leela. Means Krishna's name is there. Actually, many times we discussed, when we chant Krishna's name nicely, nama will take you to, many times we discussed it, will take you to rupa, rupa will take you to nama, rupa, guna characteristics, qualities, and leela, pastimes. So this is like in a nama dhyanam, rupa dhyanam, guna dhyanam, and leela dhyanam. So these four things, nama, rupa, guna, leela, in smaranam stage, actually we are not so focused. I mean, we are focusing. It's coming. We are trying to focus on the holy name. Sometimes we are trying to focus on Krishna's form, you know, his qualities and the pastime. Actually, we are told to just chant and hear. I mean, you all agree with that, right? You know? So, what is that? In smaranam, sometimes we try to, you know, just hearing and chanting, chanting and hearing. Arishna. Sometimes we drift to Krishna's Rupa Dhyana. Sometimes we drift to his qualities, and then we drift to past him. So we are not steady. But the next level is Dharana. Dharana means we become internal. So we become internal. We become internal and we try to really, really focus, you know. So if we enter the internal dharana, means we don't pay attention to sense objects or externals, and we try to internalize andar, you know, antarmukham, not bahyamukham. So when we internalize our consciousness, otherwise, you know, externally what happens? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. What is that? Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Krishna Hare Hare. What is this? So what we do is, you all agree, right? Do you agree? So means our consciousness is external. Our consciousness is external. But when we internalize our consciousness, and we'll be able to connect to form, nama, holy name. Then slowly nama will take us to rupa, Krishna's form. The Krishna that we love most, you know, Adha Gopi Janavallava, Radha Gopi, whatever, you know. It's your form, you love, that form will come, you know, the trupa, you know. So then, you know, just a little bit, not so much actually. No? It comes and goes. Then the next level is dhyana. Rupa Goswami mentions in dhyana stage, dharana means we are internalizing, but coming and going, pictures are coming and going, the rupa, you know. So we are able to a little bit connect to the, what is, you know, Krishna's name, Krishna's form, Krishna's qualities and leelas. But in a dhyana stage, you know, dhyana stage, what happens? Mind is fixed. Mind is fixed and we are focused. Then what happens? When you close your eyes, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, So when we chant, I know the holy name, Nama Rupa Guna Leela, you know. So but basically you're connected to the holy name, you know. Then what happens? then Krishna's mercy is there. This Nama will translate Rupa to Guna and to Leela. Then the next stage is there called Anusmruti. Dhruva Anusmruti. Dhruva or Anusmruti. Means here you are fixed. Fourth stage. You know? So here the meditation becomes uninterrupted. In the dhyana stage also the meditation is interrupted at times. But Anus Dhruvana Smriti, we studied this in Nectar of Instruction actually. Meditation becomes uninterrupted and deep, you know, deep and then we get the taste. Like for, if you see most of the people, our majority, 99.99%. What do you like? People say, I like prasad, I like kirtan, I like lectures. But we don't see anybody liking the chanting actually. Or if you ask them, what is the most difficult anga of the Hare Krishna bhakti process? We all agree without doubt. What is that?
Chanting, Prabhuji.
So, why? Because of the impurities of the heart, uncontrolled mind, and we have all these degrees. But why can't I control my mind for 5 minutes? And it is the same after 5-10 years also, but of course it becomes much better, you know. So, but when we find, you know, when we on the stage of dhyan, and stage of dhruva anusmruti, we find taste. Because mind listens, and you do whatever you want to do, and mind longs to. You know, right? You know, dharet atmanam, 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 osavatet, atmaivi atmanovandar, atmaivari pratmana. No? Uncontrolled mind is the worst enemy. Controlled mind is the best friend. When mind is controlled, then what happens? Mind pulls you, chalo, chalo, jap karenge. And no, what is impossible if you just have a class? And here, non-stop, so that meditation becomes fixed, uninterrupted, and you find this. Then the next level is what? Samadhi, absorption. You know, yatadipo nivasaste nivasasto nengate sopamaskrita yogino ita chittasya. When there is a candle, lit candle, when the can, you know, if you light a candle and keep it in a place where there is no air. The flame just burns without flickering, right? Steady. Likewise, the mind of a sadhaka is so steady at the lotus feet of Krishna. All the name, nama rupa guna lila, it flows. And one devotee no names in his calm. Yeah, when I chant, just all the pastimes come. Actually, no. So many devotees said that. I said, wow, they're very advanced, I thought. You know, one Prabhupada's disciple, she said, you know, what is the Krishna pastimes for? As soon as I chant, my Krishna's pastimes come. I said, wow, advanced. So without the interruption, when you're able to, you know, not that, what is the pastime? Not like that. That's wrong, actually. We should not bring Krishna forcefully. So when I started chanting, devotees said, we should not imagine. People ask this question, should we imagine? No, we should not imagine. Instead, we should have Krishna picture in front and we meditate on feet. That's better. We meditate on Krishna's form, Radharani's form, Radha Gopijanal form, whatever. You know, Govindadev, Gopinath, Radha Gopinath, Radha, Madan Mohan, whichever, you know. But we should not like, so, Hare Krishna. We should not forcefully bring, because mind is not presenting, that is, you are forcing Krishna to come. But when Krishna comes automatically, and you are able to meditate on that, that is very good. That's higher stage. What is that in Maharaj's name? Bhakti Rasayana said. But higher than that is, when the pastimes come, one more devotee is there. Very wonderful book distributor. You know, everyone is telling we are struggling. He said, you know, when I chant, just pastimes come in the mind. But we should not artificially try this. You know, I never tried. Anyway, the next level is Samadhi. You know, Samadhi stage. You know, what is that? So Jiva Goswami says this is when the only object of meditation is spontaneously manifested in the totality of the mind. In other words, without effort. You know. So in this stage we get the mercy. Krishna's mercy descends. You know, that spiritual world descends into your mind. Kula Krundavandam Krishna's mercy. That Tantaranga Shakti Shrimad Radharani's Krupa, you know. Everything, you know. So very effortlessly you do sadhana. You know. So what is that? Srila Prabhupada, which always said is focus, meditate, smaranam, remembrance. And Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, even conditioned stage. Even in a conditioned stage, as long as still impurities are there, three things are important. What is that? Chanting, association, and kirtan, association, and a discussion of philosophy, discussion of Srimad Bhagavatam. Krishna Katha, basically. As long as we do these things in an impurity, another stage, you know, they will maintain us. What are those three? Kirtana. Kirtana means chanting, association with the devotees, and discussion of a philosophy in the association of devotees. Either Bhagavatam or any Krishna Katha, you know. That is very good. That is very nourishing. So, but here what happens? Smaranam, remembrance. So, Raghunath Das Goswami is a Nitya Siddha devotee, is a Prayojanacharya, you know. So, you know, you remember, devotee is not always, you're not the body or spirit soul, no envy, it doesn't work. No greed, no lust, no pride, no, we also need some, what do you call, rasa, right? Whenever you tell a story of like a deity story, everyone likes it. You agree or not? You know?
Yes, so
we like why? So it's not, it's more or less like, you know, oh, you're not the body of spirit. So we know that. And we heard it. You know, we may not have realized it. And, you know, envy is bad, lust is bad, greed is bad. Okay, we are trying. We know that. But when we need rasa, some positive, You know, so we need both, actually. So Raghunandas Goswami says, one Radharani, Krishna and Radharani, they were in Radhakunda. You know, and Radharani was with all the Sakhis. You know. Nectar of instruction culminates in the glory of Radhakunda, actually. You know? The nectar of instruction, Rupa Goswami, nectar of instruction culminates with the glories of Radhakunda. So Krishna and Radharani, they were in the, you know, with the Radharani was with all the Sakis. So they were splashing water. They are splashing water each other. Krishna, what he did, he splashed the water on the face of Radharani and right on her face. And Radharani, you know, like this. And all the Sakis became upset. No, Krishna should not do like this. Then Radharani, you know, she fled, you know, she disappeared. So when the water, everything subsided, then Krishna did not see Radharani. Where is Radharani? So Radharani was missing. Radharani went and, she hid. So Krishna started searching for Radharani. And everywhere Krishna was seeing gold. You know, Krishna was seeing that golden color. So there are lotuses. Radharani was hiding behind the lotus. Radharani's breath is like honey. So all the bumblebees, they were actually, you know, gathering. Krishna knew. Wherever the bumblebees go, that's where Radharani is there. So Krishna went and found Radharani. So what is that? Raghunath Das Goswami. This is Raghunath Das Goswami's meditation. You all agree? You know, it is easy to read Bhagavatam. It's more easy to read Bhagavatam than Bhagavad Gita. Why? Bhagavad Gita is just philosophy. But Bhagavatam, at least there is a running story. Amrish Maharaj, you know. For people, what is simple proof? We are conditioned souls. Amrish Maharaj story, we have no problem reading. But suddenly Amrish Maharaj starts offering prayers. 15 pages to go to Sudarshan Chakra. Prayers we have to read. Our ego is so high, even we cannot appreciate, glorification of Krishna. You know, we want enjoyment. You know, this is Krishna's glorification. I know. Okay, good. Turn the pages. All right. Anyway, this is, but the verse 9 means what? We have crossed all those stages. We are in a pure transcendental spiritual platform. So we should have that type of mindset. You know? Whatever mindset, we don't even want name and fame. So we are on the bhava stage we crossed. We are on prema stage. On prema stage, these things are happening. Raghunath Das Goswami is writing. So what is our meditation? Krishna as the moon of Vrindavan. Tvam Krishna he pralaya koti shatantare. You know, so what is that? Bilamangala Thakur, he says this. I was reading actually Srimad Bhagavatam 10th canto. When Krishna first time went to Mathura, Mathura Vasi saw Krishna. I don't know how many of you had the habit of eating sugar candy, you know, or, you know, something you love most. Everyone felt Krishna was like that. They want to lick from distance that much beauty, Krishna. You know, Siddhiv, can you imagine the personification of beauty that they want to lick? This is there, you know, they want to some sort of like, you know, like chocolate, you want to eat. So young ladies fainted seeing Krishna's beauty. It doesn't happen. Do you agree? You don't faint, you don't, even if somebody is very beautiful, you don't faint. You know, maybe you look at them, you know, steady, but do you faint? Nobody faints. But when young ladies came and saw, they saw Krishna's beauty and they fainted. That is Krishna's beauty. Wow. Akarshayati iti Krishna. That is Krishna. You know? You know, what is that? One time, one young, what do you call? 2005 or 6, these Gurukulis, they had a Kuli Mela in Yurna. All these are very young, 19, 20, 90, so many girls and boys, they came. You know, people may say anything, but let me tell you one thing. Wow, they would just come and stand in front of Radha Rudan Chandra and they would stare for half an hour, 1 hour. They had that attraction for, like, you know, when you are little pure, you know, you are attracted. Krishna attract, you know, Krishna's attraction is there, but we are like rusty pins. But when instead of the rust is gone, what happens? Zip. You know, of course, Mayavadis cannot understand these things. You know? So Bilamangala Thakur says, Mraje Prasidam Navanita Choram Gopanganam Chadukula Choram. Krishna steals. He steals butter and yogurt, buttermilk. No, he steals like butter, like hearts. Aneka Janmar Jitapapa Choram. He steals all the sinful activities that we have counted in so many millions and millions of lifetimes. You know? You know? So, Rupa Goswami writes in Stavamala, what is Krishna's beauty? You know? Sri Radhikaya Hrudaya Sachoram. He stole the heart of Radharani. That is his greatness. So, actually, you know what is it? Purnachandra Prabhu, Ayendra Prabhu quotes this actually. But our little difference between Gaudiya Vaishnavism and other, you know, in Vrindavan, there are so many groups. So one time Saraswati Thakur was actually doing a parikrama of Radhakunda. And there they happened to see Raja of Bharatpur and his wife doing Radhakunda parikrama. So one of the disciples of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur said, see how dedicated they are. They're wonderful devotees of Radharani. And Saraswati Thakur, we just celebrated his appearance. Saraswati Thakur was always, he would surprise his disciples, you know, by his statements. He said, no, they are not so nice devotees of Radharani. What is their mood? So, see, like, you know, he's a king, that was a Raja of Bharatpur, but still there, as they were doing humble parikrama, but Saraswati Thakur said, no. Their mood of Radharani is actually they worship Krishna, and Radharani is very dear to Krishna. That's why they are doing Radha Parikrama. But in our case, it's a little different. We are the worshippers of Radharani, and we worship Krishna because Krishna is very dear to Radharani. There's a difference. We are the worshippers of Radharani because Krishna is connected to Radharani, we worship Krishna. Wow. So that otherwise we have nothing to do. This is Saraswati Thakur mood actually. You know, we have nothing to do with Sri Krishna's Supreme Personality of Godhead. That's why the bhakti is so intense. The bhakti is so intense. So we are telling, Saraswati Thakur is telling, we have nothing to do with Krishna. We are Radharani camp. One time, reporters came to talk to, this is India. This is India 19th century. Still the values were very high, even for reporters or anybody actually. So reporters all came, they want to inquire from Saraswati Thakur, what was this all about, this philosophy, everything. So Saraswati Thakur started talking about, explaining about the philosophy, and suddenly the Radharani name came, you know, and he told Radharani name, and Rupamanjari, the name, the Rupamanjari came, Saraswati Thakur became ecstatic. And his voice choked up and started crying, immediately got up and left. But good thing, today people would think crazy, but those days the reporters are also very advanced. Wow. I mean, they could advance that they could understand. 3 days Saraswati Thakur did not come out of his room. He didn't eat, did not sleep, did not pass, evacuate. 3 days. You know? Saraswati Thakur is a Manjuri. His father Gunamanjuri. And Saraswati Thakur is Nayanamani Manjuri, lands of Radharani. Very dear to Rupa Manjuri, Rupa Goswami. 3 days he didn't come out. Wow. No, so Krishna, Sri Radhikaya Hrudaya Sacharam. So Krishna has stolen the heart of Srimati Radharani. You know, so gold, wherever that gold is, Krishna goes for that. What is gold? You know, Radharani, golden color, Gaurangi. You know, so Radhe Vrindavaneshwari. Bhakti Devi, you know, unless she illuminates our heart with the love, where is the love? For Krishna, where is the love? We don't have. Yeah? So both energies, what is that? Lakshmi and Durga. Durga external energy, Lakshmi Devi internal energy. Both come from Radharani, Bhakti Devi. So if she illuminates our heart with her grace, then only we'll be able to understand anything and go forward. You know? So anyway, what is that? When we understand the goal of life is to be servant. Ashramat Radharani. She will present us to Krishna, right? In the childhood, actually, if child recognizes the mother, mother is the one who shows the child, this is father. Then the child accepts father. Likewise, Radharani has to recommend us to Krishna. You know? Then because Radharani is very dear to Krishna, Krishna accepts. You know? Accepts whomever Radharani recommends. It's very, very important, actually. You know? if somehow, you know, what is that? If we have any good fortune, you know, one lifetime, you know, or this lifetime. One thing is, you know, that's why, you know, we also celebrate Nityananda Prabhu Parents Day. Nityananda Prabhu, you know, if you want the grace of Radha and Krishna, you know, Nityananda Prabhu take Nityananda Prabhu shelter. Nityananda Prabhu will recommend us to Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who is non-different from Radha and Krishna. You know, so we need grace, Guru's grace. We'll continue more on this next week. You know, two more points. What is that? Lalita Sakhi and Visakha Sakhi. Lalita Sakhi is the intimate friend of Radharani, and Visakha Sakhi is the Guru. You know, so. I mean, you all agree, when you came to Krishna consciousness, we would not have thought we'll come to, we thought only Krishna, okay, I know Krishna, you know. But not Radharani, not Lalita Sakhi, not Vishakha Sakhi, not all this Unatojjwala Rasam, you know, this highest conjugal love, then Lord Chaitanya, Nityananda Prabhu, then. So these technical details, we do not know. So how and why it happened? Grace. Grace means causeless. You know? So we cannot tell, like, you know, you're chanting 16 rounds all the time and you're doing service. That is fine. Anyway, for the reason, the grace, you know, their grace flowed. So we should continue. You know, what is the proof? Grace flowed, our life changed. And we are learning these higher topics, not only just learning, applying. Right? We are applying in our life. That's why sometimes, you know, we should not, any bad habit we gave it up, any impurity we gave it up, we should not go back to pick it up. Because time is running out, you know, have to be very careful. So we'll continue on this verse next week. I have a couple of pictures to show. Then we'll go to the 10th verse. Any question or comment? Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Very nice class. We were talking about chanting.
Your voice is breaking. Your voice is breaking.
Is it audible now? Is it okay now, Prabhuji?
Are you using cell phone?
Yes, Prabhuji. Actually, Prabhuji, I'm in India. Maybe that network is not. Maybe I can type my question, Prabhuji. Meanwhile, other devotees can ask.
Okay. Any other question or comment?
Prabhuji, Hare Krishna, Dandat Pranam, Srila Prabhupada. Prabhuji, are we going to learn more about Vishakha Sakhi and Lalita Sakhi, in the, how Vishakha Sakhi is Guru and Lalita Sakhi is the most dear, most friend of
week, next week.
Okay, thank you, Prabhuji.
That is anyway, you know, we had to be, I just touched it and then that's why I said next week we'll cover that verse, you know. So, anyone has any question or comment?
Dandavat Pranam, Prabhuji. All glories to Prabhupada.
Prabhuji.
For the very deep, very enlightening class. Prabhuji, my question is, you mentioned that we should not impose this idea of bringing Rupa Guna Leela. Is there something that we need to do, Prabhuji? Like, do we need to pray for that or do we need to aspire towards that or anything?
You know, we can actually, this is the thing. When Sravanam and Kirtanam, they go very well, it will naturally translate to Smaranam, Prabhupada writes actually. You know? But artificially, forcefully trying to bring is not good. One devotee asked him recently. In this verse we saw six objects, Govardhan and Radhakund, right? So he told me he chants his first, his 16 rounds, he chants his first round from Dangati. He finishes his rounds. You know, four rounds he would go to, what is that? Anior, you know? Another two rounds, Puchri. Eight rounds. Maybe 12th round is, you know, 8 rounds Adrasaida of Dangati and 12 rounds Radhakanda, 16 rounds, okay. He does parikrama because he's so much connected to Govardhan, you know, as he chants, you know, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, you know, and then the left hand side is Gogiriraj, you know, so okay, what is that, Dangati, little go forward, this, you know. Then, you know, what is that? Charanamritakund. Then, so likewise, you can meditate. You know, because you have seen them, like, you know, you have so many times. He goes every year. So then what happens? The chanting goes very smooth. You know, it's less distractive. Or, you know, you're dressing Radha Gopijanal. You know, so Radha Gopijanal, you dress, you know, especially Brahmins. You close your eyes and, you know, what is that? Okay, I'll put the dhoti, I'll put the necklace, I'll put jewelry, and, you know, I'll put this waist belt, and I'll put the veil for Radha, and I'll put for flute, you know, the turban for Aqua is, it's a dhyanam, it's a rupa dhyanam. You know, if you do it regularly, it'll come. But we should not force it. And especially, you know, at conditioned stage, you know, people who are filled with Raja and Tamo, like Yugal Kishore Das, then sometimes it doesn't come. But we should, so, we should not force it. Yeah? That's why I said it's better to have a picture in front and chant. If you look and chant, that's fine. That's the best. Okay.
Thank you so much. Prabhuji, Praveen Prabhu has written the question in the chat.
Okay, just let me see.
Yes, Prabhuji.
Are there any prayers or services we do to get taste of the holy name? Like I heard, serving Tulsi Maharani, praying to Lord Nityananda Prabhu, reading Nityananda Charitamrita. Please enlighten what we can practice to get the taste of the holy name. You know? One thing I heard, Prabhuji, you know, what is that? Haridas Thakur tells, you know, a prostitute that you mentioned actually today, you know. What is that? Siraj Padara Krishna Pada Darsanam. You know? What is that? What is that? Karo Tulasi Sevana? No, there is one word. Achanad Pabera Krishna Padarsana. Anyway, the translation is this. Chant the name all the time and Saro Tulasi. Where you see, you will see the lotus feet of Krishna. That's what Haridas Thakur told the prostitute. You know? Yeah, Nidhyananda, actually Guru Krupa is very important. And if Guru is pleased, then Guru gives the test. So Nityananda is Guru Tattva, you know. And also we can pray for three things. Namaruchi Jivadaya Vaishnava Seva. You know, Sri Chaitanya and Lord Chaitanya, when if we pray to Lord Chaitanya, Gaurnita, you know, please should smile. Please give these three things. Namaruchi Jivadaya Vaishnava Seva. You should ask for these three things actually. You know, then Namarashi Jivadaya Vaishnava Seva. And if devotees are pleased, you know, we can also, you know, we can also ask, we should also pray to Guru, Srila Prabhupada, give me test for the holy name. But these three things are there, Namarashi Jivadaya Vaishnava Seva. Nityananda Charitamrita, fine. That's, if you say like that, Chaitanya Charitamrita also. Chaitanya Bhagavat also. You know, but if we follow the process sincerely, bhakti process, and that has to be bestowed by Krishna Prabhu, that our taste for the holy name Krishna has to give. You know, so I don't know, and I mean, apart from what you have written, I really do not know the specific things. But one thing, you know, Haridas Thakur says, rendering service to Tulsi, and if you chant in the association of devotees, and you know, if you dedicatedly serve a guru, then they will bestow that. That's what I can tell. Any other question or comment? Yeah. So, in a couple of weeks to come, we'll be finishing because we are in 9th verse, 10th, 11th, and 12th. We are actually, you know, we are done, but hope you are able to, what do you call it, relish the manasiksha.